Hi, I'm Milena and welcome back to my channel. Today I want to share another very exciting thing with you guys. Somehow there have been a lot of exciting things I've been making. Basically with all these projects I've been working on them for weeks and they have all finished at the same time. So that means that these videos are coming really quickly after one another. But this project is finished and I want to talk to you guys about it. Of course you've seen it in the thumbnail, but me and my dad made a mini free library. It's been up and running for about a week. The mini library is at my parents' house, not at my house, so I'm not entirely sure, but I think it has already been visited twice. I did notice that at least one book was taken. So clearly it was my idea to make a mini library and I dragged my dad into it. It sounds like he was reluctant. He really wasn't. He was really excited to work on it as well, but I got the idea, of course, I think from YouTube, from Instagram, because I think mini libraries is something we're all together discovering as a way to be more sustainable with our books, in a way to make reading a more budget-friendly activity, but I think also just showing your passion and sharing your passion with everyone. A few weeks back, Boy and I went on a mini library tour in our neighborhood and it was a lot of fun and I got a lot of inspiration, of course, from Pinterest as well. So we decided to put a mini library near their house because it's more a place where people walk by, run by. It's kind of on this route where a lot of people take their Sunday hikes. So this video is not going to be a how-to because, I mean, my dad isn't an amateur when it comes to building. He has built a lot around their home, but I am, and I have tried this for the first time, so this is not a how-to video. I did do a lot of research on the internet and luckily there was a local website that gave a lot of information, which I'm really very grateful for. I will link it down below, so if you live in the Netherlands as well, if you're Dutch or if you can read Dutch, then those tips are amazing. I think we definitely avoided some mistakes because of that website, because they gave a lot of good tips, but this video is just going to be our journey in building it. I have some time lapses, I have some clips in which we are building, in which I ask my dad some questions. I filmed a little bit where I'm picking books from my shelves to put into the mini library. Without further ado, I hope that you like it. The first thing we had to do was, of course, get a cabinet. And most cabinets are built for indoors, so we thought it would be okay. We didn't really want to build anything from scratch because, first of all, that's a lot of work. Second of all, it's quite expensive. Building something yourself seems like a budget-friendly option because you are doing most of the work, but often it's not because materials are incredibly expensive, especially when you need good quality and a cabinet needs to stand outside. So what we wanted to do is go to the thrift store and get a cabinet over there. So we expected to have to visit a few thrift stores or at least go to the same one multiple times, but on our first trip there we found a old black medicine cabinet. I think it was a medicine cabinet, or I'm not really sure what it was used for. There was just one shelf in the middle. It was a painted cabinet, it was black, and it was definitely an indoor cabinet. But we both kind of took a look at it and we did see options to make it an outdoor cabinet, to make it weather resistant, and it was super cheap. It was under 10 euros, so we decided to buy it, and we did have faith that it would work out pretty well. It was also under 10 euros, so we could just take it back to the thrift store and lose only 10 euros if it wasn't going to work out. Luckily it did, clearly, because you're watching this video. No, the first cabinet we found worked out. So once we bought it, my dad took it home and he cut out some shapes for little windows because most mini libraries are open and it's really nice because you can see the books inside and you can actually see what it is, and it's way more inviting when you can see the books inside. So we really wanted that. After he did that, I took it home and I started my journey for as far as my skills would take me. Let's head back to the past and see my amateur journey. Hi, it is the 5th of July, I think, and I am in our very messy shed right now. I'm going to show you what the current situation with the mini library is. So, as you could see last time, I bought some wood for the backside because, I'll show you, because the back of the cabinet is very indoorsy, so I need to replace that with that wood. Also, when I remove the backside, I can very easily paint
the inside. So my dad brought this one over and he first made these holes. He cut out the front. After I've painted it, he's going to put glass in it so that you can see the books from the outside. Max is very interested in what I'm making. It has one shelf that I need to give a good clean and I want to paint the inside white. These are all the things I'm going to need. Some sandpaper, sander, paint. What I'm hoping to do today is to sand everything, but I'm going to sand these bits, sand over the black a little bit, because of course if I'm going to make it light blue, I first have to do I think one or two layers of white. So the store sold it for me in the right measurements and I need to sand that of course as well. And I need to clean up our shed a little bit because I was planning to do this out here in the garden on this little table that we have, but I don't know if you can see the air, it's definitely going to rain. And tomorrow and the day after tomorrow it's going to rain as well, so I'm going to have to do at least a painting inside. Okay, I have a semi... well, I haven't cleaned, but I have put a lot of boxes away. And so now I can put the table in here when I'm going to paint. I want to let it dry when it's going to rain. But for now, I'm first going to do the sanding outside, because I don't want all that shit in the... yeah, so I'm going to do that now. Started to rain. Need to move it inside now. Yes, I removed the backside finally. I had to get a little bit aggressive and I didn't film that just for my own reputation. But look, okay. I know that the other part fits, but now it's stopped raining again, so I think I'm going to take this outside again and sand it. Coat of white paints on. It's looking pretty good. It's not yet done. You can still see that it needs a third layer at some places. But tomorrow I'm going to finish the inside and I'm going to use some kit to close like these kind of lines on the outside. And then when that's dry, it will take quite a while, I can do the blue paint on the outside. Okay, so the back is on. I used wood glue, so it's drying right now, and when it's dry I'm going to use nails to make it extra secure, and the inside is now done and I need to fill all the holes with this bad boy. I think I did a decent job though on the inside. Fill it all up. Needs another coat of paint, but
Hi, welcome to my bookshelves. It is time to find some books to put in a mini library. I have found a few that were downstairs or that were in boys' bookcase. She gave permission for, but I thought we could row my shelves together and see what books I want to unhaul or I have doubles of, because some books I have doubles and I don't need that, of course. So one of the books I have three editions from is Wuthering Heights. This is a Dutch translation and I really want to put as much Dutch translations into the mini library because, of course, I live in the Netherlands and I don't want to assume that people want to read in English, so I want to put as many Dutch books in there as possible. I have Pet Sematary by Stephen King. This is an English edition, but I think that's pretty clear. I read this and DNF'd it. Stephen King is just not for me, but I know he is super popular, so I think this one won't be long there. Then I have some Dutch literature. This one I had to read for college. It's a very popular author called Peter Buwalda. I think his books are okay, but I'm not a big fan, but I know other people are, so that will be a good addition as well. I found another double, and that is Good Omens, which also still has a bookmark in it, which probably means it's from Boyes Bookshelves. A Dutch historical fiction, which I gave to my grandma and bought her this book because I thought she would like it, and she said she did. But this one is going into the mini library as well. Pretty new release, so I think this one will be gone quite quickly too. So we have quite a bit. I know my dad has a stack as well. I'm not going to put it too full in the beginning because I want people to be able to add books as well, and that it's not entirely full. But I think we can add a few more. So let's head over to the shelves. So this is my lower shelf, which is often the books that are not very high priority for me. So I right away see a historical fiction that I really haven't touched in years. This is a Second World War historical fiction. It was translated from German, I think. That is it from this shelf, because this one is... Oh no, I think I'm going to add this one as well, The Children's Act. Boy and I read this together, we liked it, but not... I think not enough to keep it. And it's a popular author, so... going to add this one as well. Okay, and then one shelf above that, I think I may have some doubles over here. Yeah, I think I'm going to add this one. This is a novel from a Dutch comedian, Pauline Cornelissen. She's really very popular, so I think this will be a great addition to the mini library as well. I have all my red books. This one I got secondhand. I thought it was pretty funny, but not something I'm going to read again. So we can add this one as well. And this one I tried to read two times, DNF'd it. I think it's even my dad's edition and he DNF'd it as well, I think. Which is The Shadow of the Wind by Carlos Ruiz Zafón. Translated from Spanish. Super popular book, so going to make someone happy with this. I think that's quite enough because our library is quite small. This is a mystery, I know. I'm not going to read. I tried it, but it wasn't really for me. So maybe I'll add this too. Then we have a mystery. So I think I'm going to leave it here. Hi, I'm back. That was building the mini library. There are a few things that I found online that were very helpful. They advised to get a moisture absorber. I just got this plastic bullet with some grind, I think, in there. And you put it in the mini library and it absorbs the moisture. And you just have to replace it, I think, every month or something like that. It avoids the moisture coming into the books. So that was one thing we did to make sure that the books were okay, that they stayed in a good condition. Another thing I did to make sure that people knew that the mini library was there, because a lot of people like myself go on mini library tours. A local organization made an entire list, so I made sure that we got on that list, and there are some websites. They exist internationally as well, and I would definitely advise you, if you want to go on a mini library tour, to use one of those websites. So I submitted the mini library to all the local websites, and then it was time to place it, which my dad could have done by himself, but I wanted to make it a moment. Boy and I went over there and we placed the mini library. So I'm at my parents' house today and the mini library is finished, so I'm going to show it to you guys, and then we're going to place it near the road. Hoe heb je dat glas gedaan?
Ik heb het uitgesneden en erachter geplakt. Hier wel.
Cool. Thank you. Ja, de introvert rent snel weg voor de camera. So this is 5 minutes after we placed it. It's put to the test right away, the poor thing. So I'll let you know if he survived. Or, well, it's still raining. We're going to see if it survived. Oh. Er is wel. Ik ga snel weer dicht doen. Er is hier een beetje water.
Oh ja.
After we placed it, we really loved it. We were both really happy with it. Placement was great. It was a good way for people to get to the library very easily, but my parents still had their privacy. We did want some sort of sign, some sort of letters, but neither of us has really pretty handwriting, but my mom does. So she painted the name of the mini library on the side, which is Buiten Beep, meaning outdoor library. And Beep is a very short B word, but it's short for bibliotheek, which is library in Dutch. But most Dutch people say beep because bibliotheek is way too long, people. It's long, too long. And we used outdoor, buiten, because my parents, their business also starts with the word outdoor. So it kind of fitted their business on their land. And I really love it. I really love that it fits. And my mom also used a marker to say leave one, take one, because that's kind of how mini libraries work. Although I personally don't really mind if people just take one and don't leave one, because I always have enough books to put in there. I was excited to make a mini library and become part of the local community a little bit, I feel. But I also really like that we now have a designated place to unhaul our books and make other people happy with it. Of course, I'm not going to put books in there that I really dislike, because that just feels a little bit wrong. I did put a few books in there that I didn't personally love, but I know other people love. I think that's what happens often in a mini library. You know other people love it, but you didn't love it and you still put it in. I think the quality of your mini library definitely goes down if you just put your unhauled books in there because you thought they were bad books. So that's not how I want to do this, but I'm very curious how this is going to work. I'm very curious if it will be popular in the area. I know that there are a few other mini libraries in the area as well, so I hope people will add our mini library to their route. And I want to just add some appreciation for my wonderful mom and dad. First of all, that their crazy daughter has an idea for their home to add to their home and that they're okay with that. I think they're used to me being a little bit like that, but not to force my ideas on them. And I'm just so grateful that they were okay with that. And not just okay with that, but that they got really excited that my dad did so much of the more difficult parts of the building, because the windows, I don't think I could have done that, at least not in a presentable and weatherproof way. And the painting my mom did, I just really appreciate that, and I just want to thank them for their support. And I want to thank you so much for watching this video, and I will let you know how the mini library is doing in upcoming weekly reading vlogs. When I visit my parents, I'll give you a little sneak peek of the books that are taken and the books that are added. I hope that you have a lovely, lovely evening or day or wherever you are, and I hope to see you in another video. Doei! Thank you.